There's Roland putting the first piece of liner down. Very nice.
Oh, fuck. That hurt like hell.
So this is DuraLiner with a flex part, a 5 foot piece of flex. And we've got our DuraLiner insulation on here. And we've also got this protective wire mesh stretched on that serves to stop the foil from ripping and the insulation from separating on the, on that piece of flex. Up here it's a double wall liner and a stainless inside here, and it's a 2-inch clearance on it. DuraLiner bottom section.
So we pulled these up on our safety line. 4 foot sections of DuraVent. It's got a clamp on it that holds it up. This type of system is supported by the top. So it's got a clamp around the chimney.
Hi there.
It's held up. Hi. So now this system is a 6-inch system. It works. You have to put 4 rivets in. The reason for that is when you put stainless screws into a pipe, a chimney, the stainless can expand at a different rate depending on the screw. It expands at a different rate than the pipe expands and contracts and can actually walk its way out. With this system being held from the top, it gets 4 rivets and it does not, the rivets can't walk out. They supply their own rivets, so if it falls apart, it's basically their fault, but they've got a certain tested system. It's a listed system, so the rivets are all part of that. They're labeled as well, and then the stainless doesn't walk out. If you have a screw that walks out on a top hung system, the whole bottom can fall down on it, leaving an incomplete section of liner that nobody knows about in the middle of the chimney. So that's DuraLiner inside of an old chimney pot. Looks really nice and allows you to keep the look of the house. Here's a couple more over there. The age of the houses in this area are a bit newer than this one, so it's nice to retain the type of house this is, the type of style of house it is.